Look, it has pavement. It is just beautiful out today. We'll start at the back of the cemetery. As you can see, this one has started to fall into disrepair as well. There is definitely some evidence that people have been coming recently to take care of some of the graves, but a lot of the gravestones are starting to become covered in the brush. That looks like maybe either a decorative piece or a piece of an angel wing, possibly. I believe there used to be an angel statue somewhere. You know, that one's cool because even though it's so old, 1833. Still very legible. And it may actually be because the fact that the cemetery has fallen into such disrepair. You know, it's right below the bush, so during the summertime, it's got lots of cover. And it really probably was lucky. It got saved from a lot of the sunlight and the rain. '77 to 1878, so that was a fairly young child. Here's a family member, looks like. Same last name. Looks like 1880s. This apparently, as you can see, was a gravestone that was put up by the children. Now there's something that used to be on the top here. I don't see it laying around. It may have been stolen over the years. Some people are very disrespectful, unfortunately. Now these appear to have settled into the ground. It doesn't look like they were originally this way. They'll probably just have been on the ground for so many years that they've slowly settled this far in that it almost appears as if they were meant to be that way. You can see all of these here were children. They have a 9-year-old, 7-year-old approximately, less than a 1-year-old, and then a 3-year-old. It looks like this stone here in the middle is probably another gravestone. It may have been a family member, the mother or father, that died later on and were buried next to their children. Oh, I forgot about this. This is really cool. It's been years since I've been here, but this is a stone. It is etched to look like a growing tree. Or actually, it looks like it's supposed to be a stump of a tree that has ivy growing on it. Just an amazing old gravestone. You can imagine, was it 1842, how much something like this would have cost. And there's where it used to stand. It's almost too bad that no one's tried to put that one back up. That thing is so cool. These here are probably the ones that have family members that are still alive today and regularly come back and check on things. They're fairly new and well taken care of. I'm gonna skip over here, I hear something. Let's see, there's another grave in the middle. What is this bird doing? Oh, it's a woodpecker. I have never heard a woodpecker peck that softly. This 1861 to 1917, as you can see the hearts around it. So this is an interesting one here. If you'll notice, 1811 to 1864. Now that is during the Civil War. So this may have actually been somebody that went off to war and died in battle. It'd be interesting to look up and see if there is anything available. I don't know how easy it is to search for Civil War era soldiers. Aging on this one is just fantastic. That looks so cool. This is odd. See, this stone here is sunk down. It usually means that the casket is rotted away. Great example. You can see where the two gravestones used to be, or not gravestones, excuse me, the two caskets would have been positioned in front of the gravestones, and there's about a good foot dip in the ground. It's also one of the ways to tell when you're in an older graveyard, if some of the gravestones have been removed, but the bodies have not. It's probably the case right here. One of the caskets from in front of us would probably be situated in that direction, so it's probably a sign that there used to be gravestones here at one time, and somebody may have taken them or moved them. Beautiful sunset out though. Now usually this area is really dead. You can kind of see all the traffic here. For being a smaller town and actually being out in the country, this place is just hopping right now. This is so unusual. When I used to come to this place years ago, it was always dead. Let's see, here's an odd one. We have a single letter, either an M or a W, which has been balanced on top of two other stones. I wouldn't guess it was like that originally. Here's another huge stone. You can see back here that there's some fairly new fake flowers. Oh, I don't know how they got thrown all the way back here. I'd set them back up, but I don't know if they'd be so tattered it'd just end up looking tackier than it did before. Another child. I don't know what this is. Oh. That was a marker. I'll leave that cleaned off and right there. I don't want to put it someplace where it's not supposed to be. But it definitely deserves to be clean. And you see here too where there used to be a vase. There's still someone that's coming and putting fairly recently, the fake flowers. That might have been where those fake flowers from over in the bushes came from. They may have changed them, even though it ended up that the flowers in the bushes are actually in better shape. But you can see how the vase is now falling apart and doesn't even exist anymore, but people are still coming to put the flowers in them. I wonder if that's the sign of just a observer like me. If I were family, I don't know. I might save up a few $100 and put a new vase there instead of just bringing $10 flowers. But I mean, everybody's on a different budget, so who am I to say? Here's a few newer ones. So you can see, they were born in the 1800s. Right before the Civil War, and died in the 1930s. And this is an interesting one here. It just says Father on it. but I'm guessing it's connected to this main stone here. Looks like the father would be Samuel, and then we have mother over here. It would be Dora. Wow. You think that's about the size of four plots? And there's nobody else. I wonder if they originally and possibly intended for their children to be buried there along with them. But as life often does, it screwed the plans up, and they were eventually buried with their spouses and spouses' families, possibly. And there's another father and mother stone over here. It looks like there may have originally been a stone. It may have been this stone, in fact. So you can see, it's a husband and wife stone. And then here's a third. As you can see, that likely is their daughter. No, it is not. Here's another really deteriorated stone. See, this looks like one, and maybe a family came in later on and replaced the stone with a new stone, because it looks like something has fallen off into the ground, which is more similar to a lot of the older stones, and then there's a newer stone sitting on top. So this is it, another really cool cemetery, starting to fall into a state of disrepair. Possibly a few soldiers from the Civil War. Officially, in this area at least, these cemeteries all close at dusk. Anytime after dark, you usually won't get arrested, but the police will escort you out of places like this. I'm guessing it's fairly similar anywhere you go. But it is specifically department policy here to throw out anybody in a cemetery after dark. Another amazing cemetery from the Civil War era. Hope everybody enjoyed it. We'll be doing these actually fairly often, maybe. There's quite a few older cemeteries like this that we might be checking out. I don't want to make it too often, as I do want some more diversity and locations. So we'll be breaking them up a little bit, but definitely need to do this again. Very cool places.